Hey guys, Flip Otaku, and today I'm doing an Otaku haul. An Otaku haul is going to be a new thing where instead of just having a manga haul every month, every so often I'm just going to do a video showing off the new games I got, new anime, new manga, and it's all going to be rolled into Otaku hauls, and I'm going to number them. So, if I do this for 5 years and I have 500, it's going to be Otaku haul number 500. But I am switching up the content a little bit on the channel, guys. I have just done mainly manga first impressions and manga reviews in the past. And I'm still going to be doing those. I'm still going to be doing, that's mostly what I'm going to be doing. But I'm going to start incorporating some video game stuff. As you saw, I put a Devil May Cry 5 review up. And, you know, I was kind of worried if stuff wouldn't get a lot of views and a lot of good reception, but I'm done caring about that stuff. So even if something gets 20 views, I'm going to put it up. It's my channel. I want to, you know, spread some of the love of my other hobbies, which are, you know, I got my Gundams over there. I'm a huge JRPG fan. Most of the video games I play are from Japan. Huge anime fan. And I want to incorporate my love for that stuff more into my channel and talk about that stuff more. But I'm also going to be holding myself accountable. So as you guys know, I've sold some of my collection off. I'm keeping the stuff that, like, really makes me happy. I had a bunch of junk that, well, some of it's not junk. Some of it was classics. But I had a bunch of stuff that I had read, and I'm never going to go back to it. So I'm definitely going to be doing more manga reviews of series that I know more about, I'm more educated in. I'm going to be doing it by volume. So for instance, I'm going to be rereading Vagabond, and I'm probably going to be doing it by like 3 Viz Bigs at a time. I'm going to be rereading Berserk here soon, and I'm going to be doing it by arc, and then, you know, Ubo Blot, I'm going to review Ubo Blot by volume, and that's the plan going forward. I'm going to be playing a lot more games. If you guys want me to stream the games, let me know. But yeah, so let's turn this camera around. Check out Otaku Haul number 1 and see what I got recently. All right, guys, let's get into this. So funny thing about Sekiro is that I had an Amazon credit and I wanted to pick this up. And I was going to get it for PC because I have a very nice G-Sync 4K monitor. And I was so excited to play it on PC. It's going to be my first Souls-like game. Strictly on PC. I usually get it on PS4. So I thought this was going to be a digital code, because somewhere in the description it said digital code. So I was like, oh, cool. And then it said it shipped, and I was confused. So this isn't actually a disc. It's a code-shaped disc. You can try to steal that if you want. I've already, as you can tell, I'm about 13 hours into this game, and I don't know if it's just I'm in the honeymoon phase of the game, but I am definitely loving Sekiro. It's definitely, I've seen reviews say it's not a Souls game, but it definitely is. I don't understand that notion of it's not. It's very much a From Software game. It's definitely a Miyazaki game. There's about a period I was banging my head. The first 2 bosses I beat fairly easily, and then there was about a 5-hour period where I was just banging my head on this one section. And then the combat clicked instantly. And I've noticed that my friends, it's either clicked with them or it hasn't. So definitely stick with it. And it's one of the most rewarding combat systems to a video game that I've played ever. And I'm super excited to hopefully finish it up this week. I've been staying up super late. I'm tired, I'm groggy and grouchy. But yeah, Sekiro, highly recommend it. One of the best games I've played, this console generation so far. Some of my favorite boss battles from a From Software game ever, and I think this, see, I was a little worried. So, From Software, Demon's Souls, Dark Souls 1 through 3, and Bloodborne are all some of my favorite games. Dark Souls 3, 1, and Bloodborne, some of my favorite games of all time. Bloodborne being my favorite. I think this is a controversial thing to say, but I think Bloodborne, Dark Souls 3, 1, Demon's Souls, and then 2 are my favorite From Software games. This might be taking the place for second or third so far. The story
is really good. I actually like how it's narrative focused this time around instead of just getting hints and clues about the world and the lore. This is a really good game, guys. Pick it up. And then just got Mega Man 11 and Mega Man X Collection for the Switch. Played these when I was younger, so I'm letting these sit for now. The cartridge only has the first collection, and then you gotta download the second one, which I think is kind of lame. But Mega Man 11, man, has Capcom made a freaking comeback. Between this, Devil May Cry 5, and Monster Hunter World, and all the Resident Evil games. I'm not a big Resident Evil fan, but I can tell when fans are happy, and they seem pretty freaking happy about Resident Evil. This is a lot of fun. This is very hard. I spent about 3 hours on the first level, and you can kind of select which boss you want to go after first. I believe there's maybe 8 bosses. I could be wrong. But yeah, guys, if you have a Switch or even a PS4, part of the plastic still on there, pick this up. This is a really fun game, and I'm glad it's on Switch. I love the character designs. I think it's awesome. My goal this year is to beat every Mega Man game that is on the Switch, so... Alright, so a lot of people don't know this, but I'm a huge fan of bullet hells, shmups, shoot-em-ups, you know, Japanese bullet hell games, and I picked up Raiden 5. Now, this was a Xbox One exclusive, which a Japanese game being on the Xbox One exclusively is a little weird, and it got, I never bought it, I heard mixed results on it, but this got a re-release, on the PS4, as you can tell, it's the director's cut. I don't really know. The original Bullet Hell is back. Defend Earth once again as the Thunder Strike marks the glorious return of Raiden. So I know there's like some online co-op stuff in here. I'm excited to play this. I love these type of games. Very challenging, score-based games. And speaking, I got another one here. This is Deathany. This is a cave game. So Cave is one of my favorite developers in the style. And this got a Japanese release. But luckily, the PS4 is not region locked, guys. So you can play this on your PS4. And I imported it from PlayAsia. So definitely pick this up if you're into the style of game. I think this is going to be a collector's item in the future. I don't think there's that many printed. So, but yeah, I mean, I really think all the PS4 spines that are like that are kind of ugly. But yeah, pick it up, guys. Now, I've been playing the Yakuza games, and I'm going to be doing like a series impression or series review after I beat 6. But in the meantime, they made a Fist of the North Star Lost Paradise game. I don't know if I covered this before, but yeah, this looks awesome. It looks over the top. If you like Fist of the North Star, the anime is classic, some of my favorite. And we don't get a lot of Fist of the North Star stuff in the U.S. Fist of the Blue Sky sucked. It was very disappointing. But full English and Japanese voiceover. I'd probably be playing this in Japanese. But yeah, PS4 console exclusive. It's the same developer as the Yakuza games. So, you know, if you like that style, pick it up. Now, the wait is finally over, JRPG fans. Falcom. So this is a re-release of the Vita and PS3 game. So if you are going into this series, don't expect the most amazing graphics. This is the Decisive Edition. And we're getting 1, 2, and 3 this year. I believe we're getting 4 next year, hopefully. I think 3 is going to be the first time it was released in English. Man, these are just very delightful JRPGs. As you can tell, the graphics are a little outdated, but I don't play games for graphics, guys. I mean, sometimes, like I said, I'm playing Sekiro on the nice monitor, but man, I am just 4K resolution, 60 frames a second, additional Japanese voice, all DLC bonuses and optimized features. Oh man, it comes with a steel. See, I haven't even opened this yet. It comes with a steelbook. Let's bust this out and see what that steelbook looks like, guys. And oh my god, that looks beautiful. Holy shit. Falcom, you've definitely outdone yourself, guys. Let's bust this open. Oh, yeah. Wow. Is that a booklet or a poster? And sorry about that, guys. I got a phone call. Yeah, this is a booklet. This is like a really nice, thick booklet. And it's got like little character summaries in the back here. I don't want to like get it out all the way, but like little comic strips in the back. I think that's pretty cool. Definitely a nice release. It comes with some other goodies. I'm going to assume a soundtrack. Let me put my phone down, put this steel case back in here, guys. All right, yeah, so if you like JRPGs and you want something kind of Persona-esque, you know, with the social links and stuff, pick this up. Then another Falcom game is Tokyo Xanadu EX Plus. So, again, this is another Vita game, and it's got brought over to the PS4. This special edition, which comes with a bunch of crap here. Let me move some of these anime here so we can turn this box around, see what's in here. It comes with a 9-inch deluxe White Shroud figure, black card game deck, blade card game deck, 60-page art book, CD soundtrack, and collector's box. This is cheap. This was cheaper on Amazon than the base game by itself. So if you're interested in this and that deal still going, pick this up. Some extra goodies, hell yeah. Another Falcom JRPG. It's an action RPG, not turn-based, like Legends of Trails of Cold Steel. Sorry. Legend of Heroes, Trails of Cold Steel. That's a mouthful. But yeah, pick this up, guys. I've played a little bit of the Vita version like a long time ago on like a friend's Vita. And remember really enjoying it. So yeah, this is a nice box. And I have opened it, but I'm going to put the figure together here soon. So I have a good JRPG lot to play after I beat Sekiro. Now let's get into anime/DVDs. Picked up Towano Kion. This is a six-part movie from Studio Bones. Bones is one of my favorite studios. It's a good film series. I've seen the first handful. I haven't seen all of them, but I remember being really intrigued by it, getting some X-Men vibes. Pick this up, Sentai Filmworks, man. They've been putting out some good stuff for a good price, and it's nice to have all six movies in one release on two discs instead of having to buy them one by one. And then we got Starfleet. So Starfleet was created by Go Nagai, of Devilman fame and Mazinger Z fame. This is a puppet space opera show. It's 49 episodes on one Blu-ray disc, I believe. It's standard definition. I don't really care. The fact that we even got this in English is nuts. I have seen some of this, and it's just so much fun. It's so cheesy. It's so corny, but I love it. you guys gotta watch this. It's like what's that movie from the South Park guys? It's like Team America, but it kind of takes itself seriously. God, some of those characters are god-awful. But it's fun, so check it out, guys. And I also feel like, so Go is such a monumental figure in anime and manga. And I feel like recently with the Devilman Crybaby anime release, he's been getting a lot of love. And I think he deserves every ounce of it. He is just such a creative force in this medium, and I'm so glad that we got Starfleet. I think it's so ridiculous. Then we got My Hero Academia, Two Heroes. This came today, actually. Haven't watched it yet, and I'm really, really excited to watch this. Actually, guys, it comes with a Funimation digital copy. I'm gonna go ahead and give it to you guys. I have the Blu-ray. So let's bust this open. You guys get to look at my wrist again. So there you guys go. Pause the video. Let me know who got the code down below, okay? Pause this video right there. There you go. There's the code. Let me know which one of you savages gets this. I'm a huge My Hero fan. I think My Hero might be the best shonen ever. It's definitely the most enjoyable shonen that I've read and watched. In my opinion, it's just... People say it's cliched, and
but it does everything a shonen is supposed to do and nails it, like knocks it out of the park. And I heard this movie is very high quality, so I'm excited to dive into it. I probably will watch it with my wife. She actually likes My Hero Academia, so I think my wife looks like her a little bit.
So check it out, guys. I'm sure you guys already know all about it. And then this also came out recently, Satoshi Kon's A Perfect Blue, finally on Blu-ray. If you guys have not seen this, this is one of the, this is my top 20 films of all time. That includes like live action movies. And this is definitely in top 10 animes of all time. So if you haven't seen this, watch it. It's, I think it is, I'm tired. It is definitely the late Satoshi Kon's best work, in my opinion. So not much more I need to say about that. That's a classic. Also got Elfin Lied, or Lied. I think this is the complete collection. Yes, it says complete collection. Messed up. I'm going to be watching this with my wife. And hopefully she enjoys it. Then we got another classic, Shin Tetsujin 28, the complete 1980s TV series in the original Japanese language. Actually, Otaku Mike sent me my first pop, and it's Shin Tetsujin. So thank you, Mike. I have seen parts of this, and I remember loving it and picked it up. It's cool that we're getting... Who's putting this stuff out? Discotheque. Discotheque's been putting out a lot of classics, which I don't think are going to be selling very well in America, but I'm very grateful that we have it. Mazinger Z Infinity, the movie. This was recently released a couple years ago. It's like a high production valued Mazinger Z movie by, you know, created by the great Go Nagai. I can't wait to watch this. It looks ridiculous. And I love Mazinger Z. Then, I'm a huge Power Rangers fan, and I'm a huge Super Sentai fan.
So this is the original Super Sentai
DVD release. You know, what Power Rangers was based on. A lot of fight scenes from Power Rangers are ripped right... Are they on horses? Are ripped right from this. 50 episodes of cheesy tokusatsu goodness. So... Seiju Sentai Gengaman, the complete series. Also, got some Ultraman, the complete series, the actual live action Ultraman. 39 episodes on 4 DVDs. Badass. Super happy to have that. And then, oh, it's upside down. I got Kamen Rider built. So I love Kamen Rider, and I've been like watching it on streams. And went to Amazon, saw that they had a couple Kamen Rider DVDs, box sets available, but they are bootlegs. The quality is not terrible. I can understand why we're never going to get an official release out here in the States, because it probably won't sell. Kamen Rider is like very much just a cultural thing, but I like it. And Build, I don't think I've watched any of Build yet, so I think that's why I picked it up, was because I want to see Build. I think it's the second newest one. Then picked up a classic Ninja Scroll. You guys know all about Ninja Scroll, I'm sure. What a good movie. I'm going to be doing a review on this very soon. Watching it with my wife again. Then more Go Nagai goodness. We got Violence Jack, the complete OVA collection. I'm a huge... What can I say? I love Go. I think he's phenomenal. And Violence Jack is... a great series, and I hope, you know, Netflix does a reimagining of this. It definitely deserves it. Violence Jack, I like it maybe just a little bit more than Devilman at times, so pick this up. Hopefully that's what Seven Seas does next with the classic collection. We get some Violence Jack, guys. Then I picked up Full Metal Alchemist Brotherhood Blu-ray box set 1 and 2. These are very nice releases. They're backwards. This is 1. This is 2. Very nice releases on Blu-ray. The complete series. Full Metal Alchemist is one of... probably one of the best anime. I just started reading the manga for the first time recently. I just noticed that there's a little crack right there, but I'm probably going to throw the box away anyways. This is one of my favorite animes. I've never read the manga. I recently started reading it with the Full Metal editions. But this had such an impact on me as a kid. And it's a lot of people's favorites. And it's a lot of people's favorites for a reason. This is a phenomenal series. I don't think there's anything wrong with any of the episodes. I think it's a hit from start to finish. And I'm so happy to have these on Blu-ray. Now let's get into manga. I'm saving this for later. Picked up I Am a Hero 7 and 8. Some of the stuff I was missing from the series. Really good. Like, really, really, really good. I did my last haul video and I've read a lot more since then. The art is good. The story is good. Now, there is a little bit of a thing I'm worried about. The mangaka's father passed away towards the ending of the manga. And I believe the ending is rushed from what I understand. And it's kind of disappointing. So I'm worried about that. But I like the ending of Gantz, so, and people seem to hate that, so hopefully it's not as bad as people say, because I didn't think Gantz was as bad as people say. Then we picked up Daiwar Gelder by Samura, Haruki Samura, the creator of Blade of the Immortal. This is book two. Mine's a little damaged. Yeah, it's a little damaged. I'm a little upset about that, but hey, what can you do? Amazon screwed up a lot of my books recently, and they gave me like a pretty substantial credit on a bunch of stuff. So let's take a look. Haruki's art is, I think he's one of my favorite artists. And I like when he does violent series. I'm not a big fan of his slice of life work, which is what he's working on right now. But I don't know what's the deal with this. Information about the Japanese release of this is pretty sparse online. The first book of this came out years ago, or like a year or two ago. We just recently got this one released in the States, and then on the last page it says continued in book three. So I don't know what they're going to do with the series. It's females kicking ass. Pick it up. It's fun. And then picked up More to the Abandoned Sacred Beast. So Mike's a really big fan of this mangaka. I don't know if it's a person or if it's like a manga team, maybe is what they're called. I don't know. He's a big fan of, it's for the plot, I swear. He's a big fan of this mangaka's other work, which is Tales of Wedding Rings. And this is, I think the plot in this is a little bit more interesting. The art is, when it's good, it's really good. Like, look at that. The action scenes are really good. It takes place in the U.S. Civil War. The North was losing, and they summoned these magical beasts to win the war. So if you're reading the first couple volumes, the action scenes are a little poorly done, but it definitely gets better. And I believe Tales of Wedding Rings came after this, and from what I understand, Mike said the action is very well done. So if you want something a little bit unique, picked this up. Volume 7 is recently new, and it's put out by Vertical, which is one of my favorite publishers. And then, man, so this is, I've never read this. I've never read or seen this. Someone was literally selling the first 8 books for, the covers, I gotta say, are really dang good. The first 8 books for $20, and then it got sent to the wrong person. And then I got that person's box, which was My Hero Academia. And I know nothing of Dead Man Wonderland. I will be doing a series first impression. It's one of those mangas where, like, people online either say it's their absolute favorite manga, and other people say it's too edgy for them. So I like a little bit of edge. I've been in an edgy mood lately. But the artwork is phenomenal. Jinsei Kataoka. I believe is the artist. It's a manga team. I'm excited to read this. See what it's all about. Dead Man Wonderland. Yeah, so kind of a blind buy, but also kind of like, I know it's a bloody series and a violent series, and I kind of want that. So, and next up from Lythus's recommendations, Liquid Soul. Soul number one, Liquid Chambers. What is the actual title? Soul Liquid Chambers, number one. And then, okay, so the number two and then number three. He said this was a very fun, violent series. Some of the same manga as Dance in the Vampire Bund, which I did not like very much, which I will be selling Dance in the Vampire Bund, the books that I do have in that series. I don't have it complete. I think I'm missing one book. But yeah, pick this up. We'll be doing a review. And if I like it, I'll keep it. If I don't like it, then I will probably be getting rid of it. And then here's everything Mike sent me in some. So Reincarnated Slime and Shield Hero 1 and 2 are mine. And then Mike sent me Magical Girl Spec Ops Asuka 1 through 5, or 1 through 4. Yuna and the Haunted Hot Springs. Not Lives. Napping Princess. High School Prodigies. Have It Easy Even in Another World. Hoshin Inge. Seven Deadly Sins. And then this was sent to me by... like I said, the Demon Wonderland, the guy who got my package, packaged me... Oh, yeah. I got something else for this person. So this person wrote me a note and said, Filippo, take these books. It wasn't even... The person didn't have to do this. He literally got the wrong box, opened it, and then included two manga. So I got this, which is Concrete Revolution, I believe. The anime is supposed to be good. I've never even heard of it. And then he also included Satoshi Kon's Opus, which is pretty nuts that he included this, because this is, like, a really beloved book. And I'm going to be checking it out. Like, he included two of these. And whoever you are, I don't know your name, but thank you so much. Like, that's so nice of you. And we're getting, I saved the best for last. It's here, guys. It's finally fucking here. Berserk Deluxe Edition. I got this. There was a thing on Amazon in November, December where this was like sub $20. So I got it there. It's been out in other places. Look at that. Look how thick that is. Look how beautiful that is. It's been out in other places for a couple weeks, I believe, actually. Like maybe 2 weeks. But yeah, guys, it's beautiful. And for size comparison, I do have this is a standard volume. Berserk. So that is how much bigger
the deluxe edition is. It is insane. This is
my dream come true. I'm a huge, you guys know, I talk about it a lot. Look at that artwork in this format. Just, oh man.
These are 3-in-1s. Look at that. These are 3-in-1s. They're very nicely bound. I believe it is a sewn binding. We do get a bookmark ribbon on the very top there, which Dark Horse usually does with their library editions. This isn't as big as a library edition, but I believe this is as big as a standard comic hardcover from Dark Horse. So let's check this out. It's a tiny bit shorter than BPRD. Oh, wait. Yeah, just a nub taller than BPRD Plague of Frogs, which is like a standard this is a standard trade format, but it's manga. We don't ever get manga in this format, guys. Like, this is insane, and I really pray to the gods that Dark Horse continues us and sees us through, but I also pray to the gods that Dark Horse puts out volume 40, okay? Volume 40 is out in Japan. Come on, Dark Horse, please do not let me down. I am so in love with this book. When I got it, I told my wife, I go, man, I'm almost as happy as on our wedding day. And she kind of got offended, but I was just joking. Yeah, look at that beautiful embossed spine. The brand of sacrifice is indented. Parental advisory sticker. I might peel that off. I'm not sure. But yeah, so these are 3-in-1s. There's 3 total, including this, solicited for this year. So once I will be doing a review, this is how I will be doing my reviews of Berserk. I will be covering what's included in this. And also, something I was worried about was I love the covers for the manga, the standard volumes. They do include the covers of the manga in the back here. So this is volume 3 art, volume 1, volume 2. The page quality is really nice, like super nice paper quality. It's better than normal. It's not as good as the Gundam hardcovers, but it's better than normal manga paper. Oh, and then I got one more thing. Sorry, guys.
Picked up the only Junji Ito book I was missing, Dissolving Classroom. Yeah, this is from Vertical. It's the only book that I did not have of his, and I'm going to be doing a review of it. Ito's one of my favorites, and I believe that's supposed to be him, right? I'm not sure. His characters all look the same. It's got, I don't know if you guys can see that, but it is up. Like, this is, this character has popped out a little bit, which is nice. Nice little detail. Yeah, you see? Man, I love Junji Ito. But yeah, guys, that was the Otaku Haul, number one. Got some good stuff. This right here, all of this, I would say less than $100. Just know how to look for deals, guys, and like snag stuff when you can. Like this being sub $20, all of these being $20. I actually made money from this because the person gave me money to ship out the other box and told me to keep the change. So, yeah, that's awesome. You know, and this was like $5. Anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching. Subscribe and expect reviews, impressions of video games, manga, and anime very soon.